Remix!
It's time for another Rule of the Month. When it comes to talking rules, there's none better than longtime USGA rules official and AGA executive director, Ed Gowan.
Guess what? It's time for another Rule of the Month. I think today we're going to talk about etiquette, overseat etiquette.
Oh, the dreaded cart path only sign. That's right, golfers. Depending on where you live or where you're visiting right now, most courses are coming out of overseat. Even if the course looks green and healthy, she's still pretty fragile.
Don't leave the cart path. If you're going to make tire marks, you shouldn't be there. Just be careful you don't do damage to the golf course.
And don't do damage to your pace of play either. Cart path only doesn't mean slow play only.
If you're sharing a cart with someone else, think about pace of play.
To keep a good pace of play, you and your cart buddy need to work as a team. When the first guy gets out and heads to his ball, the other guy should be advancing the cart further down the path.
Take 3 or 4 clubs so you don't walk back and forth and delay play. That probably saves 2 or 3 minutes time. Add that up over 18 holes, we just saved an hour. A lot more fun for everybody.
A lot of overseed etiquette when it comes to pace of play really should be in play no matter what time of year it is. Playing golf is about planning your next move.
Where do you park your cart? Park it ahead of you. If there is a cart path that goes around the back of the green toward the next tee, maybe you want to park over there even if your ball's in the front of the green. So think ahead. Where are you going to put your clubs? Where are you going to park the cart? Saves time, makes it comfortable for everybody, especially the other people you're playing with. There is no rule on etiquette. There are suggestions. Being courteous is an intimate part of the game.
This has been another Rule of the Month, overseed etiquette style. Play well, golf fans.